like to ask him, because what has been just said is a global issue in terms of there is a huge number of female artists, but not too many opportunities for them. So I'd like to know if you, for being a female artist, you came across any sort of difficulties and obstacles, and how did you overcome it, if you did so?
I've never came across that. I know that this gallery has been open, very, very welcoming my art, but I didn't come across those issues. I've heard about it in the United States, same thing as in the UK, similar. But I just started and it's going well, I'm sorry. But no, I think it's, I'm using M as a name. It's just a letter. What's funny is that when people look at my paintings, they don't know I'm a woman. So when I exhibit, I don't always say I'm the artist, and I hear things, and then when they see me, they say, it's you? Yeah, it's me. So people are not expecting a woman to be painting this way. That I'm feeling, but it's not negative for me. In my case, it's never been an issue. Not yet. Hopefully not. But thank you.
Anyone else? Yes, please.
Can you expand a bit more on your decision to use this trashing process whilst you paint? And your decision to actually use, like, your you wanted to input your biological self onto your work.
You mean my saliva?
Yeah.
Is that it? Okay. There was not it's not something that it was thought. It's when I started painting, I purchased paint, canvas, but not brushes. So I would use, with like a child, I wasn't thinking that I need brushes, so I would use a dough roll to spread my paint. I would use plastic bags to paint my fingers. I didn't paint with a brush, and I would paint outside. So what was convenient was my saliva. It follows me everywhere. I didn't think of, because when you have a brush, you need water. You need a bowl of water to put the brush in. So it just never came up to my mind, and I never used it because it's not convenient. You don't always have water when you're outside. And then knowing myself, it would drop on the floor, so it's easier to use my saliva. It's part of my work, but it's not something I thought of doing. It just happened naturally. And yes, it's part of all my work. It's saliva that I use.
So when someone buys a piece, they're effectively buying literally a piece of you.
Yep.
On your DNA.
With or without saliva would be that? yeah, there is my DNA in all my paintings. Some more than others, but and it's convenient. You can paint outside anywhere, and you don't need water. I use the tube and the.
I've got a question. I'm sure you didn't wake up one day just to start drawing. You mind someone like aspired to you, so
painful. What happened, my story is that I'm adopted in a Caucasian family, and I don't have many other friends in my neighborhood where I live and everything, and I did not know my roots, my biological father. I knew I was half Asian, but I've never met anyone from my family, so I was raised with a quest of identity. I've had a problem with that. Looking at my sister, even though it's not necessarily a cultural thing, but I wanted to, since I didn't belong and feel I belong, I wanted to have something that grounds me to my room, that brings me to my room. So I asked an artist in Montreal to paint me a totem with my hair, my son's hair, something that belonged to us, to have my own little tree. And he's the one that said, you're an artist, I would like to exhibit with you. And I said, I'm not an artist, I'm paying you to paint something for me because I can't do it. He said, no, you're an artist, and I give classes, and if you want to come, you are welcome to come and learn, because he would teach me. So I went. Actually, I painted before going because I was afraid. I said, I can't paint. I'm going to see if I could do something. And I arrived at the first class with painting that he didn't believe I did, by the way. And I followed maybe, I don't know, 8 to 12 classes, because I was not a good student. I didn't listen, I didn't do the homeworks. I loved to go there because he had paint. You know, the paint was lots of paint. And he would, actually I didn't know my colors. He would ask me, what's the complementary color of, and I didn't know, I would just paint. So we stayed friends. I exhibited with them, but I didn't follow the classes because the technique or to me was too much. I just wanted to express myself, which is what I do. I was not that I'm not open to it. I wanted to learn it and do it my own way. I didn't want to follow his lead or and they saw right away I was not I didn't need to have this type of class. I don't want to get better, I just want to know myself more. It's exploration and it helps me to be balanced with myself, but to know about the techniques or what's new material that's coming in the market, I'm not interested. I prefer to try, make mistakes, because I do make mistakes sometimes and enjoy, because it's always fun, always pleasurable.
Which art movements or artists do you like or inspire you?
Inspire me in art? I really like Lautrec. Lautrec is an artist that I personally love. His painting talks to me. It's like Lautrec. He has scenes that I feel like you could almost smell the heat, the sex. The alcohol, the smoke, maybe it's to me in his colors. I like Lautrec. There's Lemire, also a Quebec artist.
Okay.
I like he's got nice yellowish whites and tints that I can't do, that I wish I could do because I tried. He's Lemire.
Can I just spell it, please?
Lemire and
L-E-M-I-E-U-X. Okay.
Yeah, just a minute. And he's got shades, and hues that I cannot even imagine doing. So maybe one day I'll try. And there's many other artists. I don't know them all. I'm not too familiar with the contemporary world because I don't go often to museums. I've been a couple of times in my life, but I'm not too open to that as it was not part of my journey. Now that I'm painting, it's interesting to discover. And even here, I'm discovering artists from Biafra. It's amazing. There's so many things. But I really come from another world. In Montreal, I didn't know that African fabric existed like that. I'm serious. When I went to Belgium, I discovered African stores where they had the fabric.
Yeah.
I freaked out. I said, wow, this is art. I was looking everywhere. To me, it was new. The food is new. There's many things that are new because people look at me and they don't think that I don't know. There are many things for me to learn. And I'm well started, I believe. Well surrounded, yeah. Thank you.
I have one question.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry. And this is a problem for a lot of artists. But how do you know when a work is finished? There are so many layers to your work. How do you know when to stop?
I guess if someone takes it off my hands, because I will paint paintings on top of paintings. Sometimes I don't have canvas and there's three paintings under a painting and I don't mind if I lose a face, if you don't take it away from me and it's there and I need to paint, either I'll take a bag, like a garbage bag, or I'll paint on anything. So when is it finished? Is it ever finished? I don't know. I don't know. I wish I could answer. But sometimes I would retouch a painting. I don't do it but you look at it later. My problem is that when I paint, I don't take the time to look at them. I was surprised this morning. I was looking at the first painting and I'm seeing different things that I didn't see because I paint and I put it aside. I rarely put it up and look at it. It's finished. It's gone. I don't, and I don't even have the space, so it's gone somewhere. I can't keep it with me in my my apartment. So I just painted and next, or repaint on the same surface. It happens. But I don't know. It's finished when it's gone.
Do you see yourself to become full-time artist? Because I know you've got other things going on.
Well, in that first year of painting, I was doing that full-time. I hope I'll have that opportunity. I would love that.
Yeah.
I need that.
What, after all of the works you've done, What drives you to keep painting and painting all the time?
When I paint, I exist. This is something that's really, for me, it's the most beautiful moment of my life when I paint. Yeah. I find myself.
Finally find myself.
I belong when I paint.
Every artist wants to become someone like a famous, like we know famous artists who are making millions or they are well known. Do you see yourself, apart from being professional or full-time painter, to become a well-known second? This is me as a brand known around the world.
I want to say something that I truly believe. When I paint, I'm rich. I don't need anything. I don't need money. I don't even need to eat. When I paint, I have everything. So whether it goes around the world or not, in my world, in my mind, in my soul and body, I'm the richest person when I paint. So whether I make it or not, or they travel, for me it's already done. Because it's here. I'm fulfilled. Yeah. It's not a question of a dollar sign. Sorry, but it's true. There's no money that could buy me. You would offer me $1 million, but I have to give you my paint. I'd say no, thank you. Because what keeps me alive is painting. Right now, and what kept me going through the hard moments of my life was painting.
So, if there was one artist, like one dead artist that you could hang out with for a day,
maybe it'll take. Yeah, I'd like to visit his scenes, yeah, probably. Have a drink with him and enjoy.
Mm-hmm. Oh, so which artist, by the way, sorry?
Lautrec, Toulouse-Lautrec.
Okay.
Yeah, probably him.
Oh.
Yeah, and because when I look at his scenes, he brings me back in time. So I would discover those years that the beginning of the century, and go out in the sceneries that, for me, they talk to me, so I would like that, go to his ballet. As you know, I voyage, because I did Cancan there, but that's probably, you know, it's something, I would have loved to be a French Cancan, I love that. One day I will go see them. I've been to Paris, to Moulin Rouge. Unfortunately, I didn't have the opportunity to go in, but next time I'm going to Paris, I'll go in and enjoy. Yeah, because I love feathers and sparkles. Yeah, I love that.
Any other questions on the phone?
Most artists don't really have one favorite work. But if you had the opportunity to say, what is the work that just gives you like your own vibes almost, when you see it, of the works I'm showing you today, what would you say?
There are many, but perhaps the Fifth Floor. That one, probably one of my favorite, yeah. Fifth Floor, yeah.
Why?
It was a moment of my life where I spent, a week and a half at the psychiatric hospital, and it's touching me, it talks to me. It's a painting that when I write, I will fly again. Well, I'm flying now, so it's something that's part of my journey that I had to live with, that I'm not ashamed of, and see, I feel I'm flying now, so it's, we have bad moments sometimes in life, bad times or harder moments, and we come out of it. This was, 2002, so years ago, and now here I am.
It is important to hear you saying that, because I think many artists go through these difficult moments. Mm-hmm. Very few of them are willing to speak about them.
Yep.
And so, you know, kudos to you for even mentioning that just now.
Well, I'm not ashamed. It's just that you don't necessarily want to explain all your art, because people, you want them to find themselves in it. Mm. But this one, to me, it's so clear. Maybe people are asking me, why Fifth Floor? Because I was on the fifth floor at the hospital. That's why. It's that simple. And then I live moments where people, there's different people in there, and you have to find yourself. There's schizophrenic people, there's people that are very violent, there's people that are really sick, there's people that are tired, and this is society, this is life. And it's a moment of rest or break in my life that I had trouble to come to terms with, but I painted it. It was better when I painted it than when I talk about it. I think it's more clear to me, the image. And then this is how I paint my life or my feelings or what I, yeah, who I am. So, no, I'm not ashamed, but it's something, it's one that I really like and that I would probably put up on my wall. Yeah, it's positive for me, it's not negative. I turn negative into positive.
Absolutely, and that's how it should be. Most artists have a style, and most people expect artists to have a style. Judging by the comments the other day, one of the things that a lot of the guests were saying that what they liked about your work was that it wasn't highly stylized. You didn't have a style per se, but with looking at all of your works, you can tell that this is one artist. So do you consider yourself to have a style in your artistic practice?
I call it trash, not because trash or trashing, because it's a lack of vocabulary or knowledge in art. When people would come to my house or when I started painting, I'd say I'm trashing. I would take a surface, a clean surface, a canvas or whatever, and I would make it, give it chaos, give it life or energy, and then I was able to work on it because I am afraid of the white canvas, like the white page for a writer or something. I don't like that. So I call it trashing, throw paint and do put toilet paper. I glue toilet paper on the surface sometimes to give it a texture. This is what I call trashing. So the styles, like I said, for me painting is the universal language. We could speak many language, being bilingual, trilingual, multilingual with my painting. I don't think I should stick to a style. If there's one, I don't know which one it is. And I don't think it's important. I'm just exploring. There are no limits. That's what I love about art. You're not limited. I could do what I want. And I could go where I want, when I want, in my mind, and that belongs to me. There's music in my head all the time, even though it's silence. I'll paint at night, I'll stay up, and then I'm in another world. Not bothering anyone, and it keeps me grounded when I paint. I'm hyperactive, and when I paint, I'm calm.
What's your biggest... your biggest, most ambitious, craziest dream for your work and your career?
ambitious, I don't know. I'll take it step by step, one day at a time. But I just hope one day I'll be able maybe to be satisfied with less. Because I'm hard to satisfy with myself, I'm very hard. So perhaps just accept more the straight line, maybe. Because for me, it has to go in all directions. It's not me if it's not busy like it is. Maybe people like it, but it goes with my brain also, my way of functioning. I just, it needs to be full or going in all directions. Maybe one day I'd like to, you know, have something in a straight line, maybe in the art, I don't know.
What do you mean in a straight line?
It's just that when I paint, and you can see that most of my paintings, lines are going in all directions. And just to have something more maybe linear would be a challenge. Not necessarily, not that I don't like what I do or that I don't find myself in what I do, but it would be a challenge to make, you know, just to be happy to paint a straight line.
Mm-hmm.
You know, that's a challenge.
Okay.
I don't think I'll ever be able to make a straight line on a canvas, you know. But a dream, I'm living my dream right now,
okay.
So I don't even see bigger. To me, it's big enough.